So I heard about the MR340 three or four years ago. It sounded awesome. 340 miles on a paddleboard. And I said, that sounds like something I want to do.
Blake said one day that he was thinking of doing the MR340, and I said, great, I will be your support crew. His wife told me before the race that the only reason she was comfortable with letting him go on this crazy 340 mile race was because I was his crew. So she figured I would prevent him from doing really, really crazy stuff.
This year there were 400 boats that started in Kansas City, and Tuesday morning everybody puts their boat in the water and they say go, and everybody starts paddling towards St. Charles, 340 miles away. There are several checkpoints along the way that you have to get to in a certain time, and if you don't meet those time limits, then you're out of the race. So my whole plan was just get past the first day and see where it stands.
Then he made the first two checkpoints, which was the plan. It was plenty of time, and he made it past the third one, and he was starting to do really well. I was in contact with his wife, Anbal, and she was also able to watch his progress. She started to notice that Blake was not only making excellent time, but he was the number one stand-up paddleboard in this race, and looked like he was gonna win, and he might even set the record.
I don't know what goes through everybody's mind, maybe what their next meal is, but I kept doing the math. When I'm gonna finish, what my rate is. I realized that I was feeling good enough and the time was working out, and I could beat the record.
All right, big wave for the folks back home.
And it was just forever, right? So it was just like the river of no return. It went on and on, and then finally I saw the bridge, that's the I-70 bridge going into St. Charles. And then we had radios, and so Victor called me on the radio and said, we can see you.
Then he lost one of his water jugs and had to paddle downriver to catch it and tie it back onto the paddleboard. This established him as someone who wouldn't even litter the river a little bit, not even to save time in a race.
I paddled up. I knew I had the record, but everybody was cheering. There was a big group there. Some friends had come to the river, and I pulled up, and it was amazing. I just couldn't even believe it.